At Special Effect, we aim to highlight the motor accessibility options, which may make gaming more accessible for some players.
In this video, we are going to look at how an Xbox Adaptive Controller can be used as an option to create a customised controller for playing Android games.
The Xbox Adaptive Controller, also known as the XAC or ZAC, is a first-party controller for Windows and Xbox, but it is also recognised as a supported controller on Android devices.
The XAC is a controller which can be used as an accessibility switch and assistive joystick interface, and also includes some buttons built in. This enables you to customise your setup with a range of switches and joysticks that you find easier to access than the buttons and sticks on a standard controller. You can use it to play Android games, which have controller support, on devices using Android 5.1.1 or later. In this video, we will show you how to connect an XAC to an Android device, and also some examples of the switches and joysticks we use with it at Special Effect. The Xbox Adaptive Controller connects in the same way that a standard Bluetooth controller would connect. You can't use a cable to connect it, you connect it using Bluetooth. Step 1. Turn on Bluetooth. The first step is to turn on your compatible Android device and open Settings. Then Connections, select Bluetooth, and turn on. You can often also access the Bluetooth setting by swiping downwards from the top of your screen and selecting the Bluetooth icon. Step 2. Turn on and sync your XAC. Next, you need to press and hold the guide button with an Xbox X icon on it to turn on your XAC, and press the sync button to the right of the Y switch port on the back of the XAC. The light on the XAC should flash rapidly, and you should see Xbox Adaptive Controller listed on the available devices list on your Android device. Step 3. Pair your XAC. Now we just select the discovered Xbox Adaptive Controller listed on your available devices. Depending on your device settings, you may need to enter your password to pair it. For this device, it required approval of the Bluetooth pairing request. Step 4. Set up your controls.
Once paired, you can plug in the combination of joysticks and switches you require to play a compatible game.
Many games will require additional inputs alongside those found on the XAC itself, so joysticks and accessibility switches will need to be added for these. Different games will require different inputs. An online search may help to discover what these are, or you may need to install and open a game to find out. For example, for Sonic the Hedgehog Classic, I would need access to the left joystick or D-pad, as well as the A button to jump. Then you plug in your preferred input method. Here we have opted for a one switch ultra stick joystick and the large button from the Logitech Adaptive Gaming Kit to give us a large joystick and button to use with a certain amount of resistance offered to activate them. We could also use a smaller low force joystick, such as this J3 one from Celtic Magic, alongside a low-force accessibility switch like this Ultralight HD one from Marblesoft, to give us lighter controls with less resistance. Some of the other joysticks we use at Special Effect with the XAC are one switch zigzags with various bases, one switch standard and low-force XAC mini joysticks, Celtic Magic Feather joystick, Praetorian Optima joystick, Evil Controller's mini XAC thumbstick, and some of the accessibility switches are AbleNet Buddy Buttons, AbleNet Spec Switches, and other switches from the Logitech Adaptive Kit. Step 5. Finding compatible games. You can find compatible games by searching for them in the search bar of the Google Play Store. We have another video showing some games which are compatible with the XAC on Android as a starting point. Please be aware certain games may cost money to buy or have in-app purchases. Depending on your Android device, you may be able to interact with the operating system using the XAC to open games. You may need to move their location to the home screen, for instance, using touchscreen to do this. To disconnect the controller, you can either hold the guide button with an Xbox X icon on it for approximately 5 seconds, or you can turn it off in your Android device's Bluetooth settings. To update your controller's firmware, use the Xbox Accessories app on an Xbox One or Series console, or on a Windows 10 or 11 PC. To charge the controller, you can use an AC adapter, which is sold separately, or connect it to an Xbox or PC.
We hope that this video has been helpful. For more information on the joysticks and buttons compatible with the XAC, please check out our XAC tag on the Game Access info site.